Hello guys, welcome to my this video, and in this JavaScript tutorial I'll show you how you can add owl carousel in your project. So guys, here I'm making a landing page. You can see here, so first of all, previously I had made this design, and here you can see the design, that is I can hover, and here is the hover effect, and I can choose from the product here. And this design I also made in previous tutorial, so if you want to add this design, so I will provide the link in description, so you can go to description and watch this video so you can add this type of design in your project. So here I will show how you can add owl carousel. So guys, here you can see I have added the owl carousel. So if I press this button, so the product is sliding, and I can slide by this mouse drag also. You can see if I drag this one, so it's sliding also. And here is the partner images. So here I did not add any button, just I can slide by this mouse. You can see here this one. So guys, in this video I will show how you can do that. So I hope it will be enjoy. And guys, if you find this video is helpful and you need this video, I mean if you don't know how to use owl carousel, so guys, I will request to like this video and please keep watching. So first of all, I will open my Visual Studio Code editor. So guys, here you can see I have opened index.html file and the style.css file. So here you may confuse, that is I have already written some code. So here I will give you the brief idea, that is this code is for this design which I have added in my previous tutorial. So I'll provide the link in description, the playlist link, so you can watch the video, and then you will make a design, and you will find this code. Okay, so here I will add the owl carousel on this product. I mean this code is this one. So here I will give you the brief idea. So here you can see this is the row bootstrap, and here I have added three column. You can see here, you can see there is the three column, and if I expand one column, so you can see the code. So this is the date, this one, you can see this one, and now image, heading, description and button. So image, heading, description and the button. So this is the code, and here I will add owl carousel. That means the owl carousel I will add in this section. But first of all guys, I have to be implement owl carousel. Okay, so I will minimize this one. So here, and the script also. So here I will explain the script, this one, because you may confuse. So this script is for this one. So if I choose any product from here, you can see, so the product is still here if I hover out the mouse. And if I choose this one by hover, and if I hover out, so the product is still here. So this is for this script. Okay, so now guys, I will start to implement owl carousel. So first of all, I will open, and here this site. Okay, so this site link I will provide in my description. So here you will get all the code of owl carousel. Actually, if you go to the owl carousel documentation, I mean official site, so there you will find more code, and you may confuse. So from that, the code I have extracted which we need actually. So here you can see this is the very simple code, and I will explain, and it's very easy to implement. So guys, here first of all, you can see I have written the CSS link. So you have to be copy this CSS link. So I will copy, and guys, here you can see the link I have break, because if I would write it in one line, so the link would be a overflow here. So that's why I break this line. So I will copy this link, and just I have to be add in my head tag. So this is the head tag, and guys, this is the custom CSS link. This is the CSS file, and that link I have added here. So you have to be do one thing, if you have the custom CSS link, and just above this custom CSS link you have to be paste the link. Okay, so I have pasted this link above this custom CSS link. I mean this external CSS page link I have added here. So above this external CSS page link, just I have pasted this link. Okay, so now I will bring it into a one line. So like this way, I will bring into one line. Okay, so this is done. So now I will show you the link, this link you can see. So this is done, I have added the CSS link. Okay, and after that, here I will just scroll, and I will open this one. So now the HTML code for slider. So I will cut the code, I mean copy from here to here. You will do the same, just you follow the step what I am doing. So then you will find the owl carousel is implemented in your project. Okay, so I copied the HTML code, and now just here I will paste this code. You can see here, this is the code I paste here, and now After that, here. So now here is the two script link. So first one is the jQuery link. You can see here. So if you did not add jQuery link, so you have to be add this jQuery link. You can see I did not add any jQuery link here. So that's why I will add the jQuery link, and this link is for Owl Carousel. So I'll copy this two script from here, and just here I will paste, and the same way I will bring it into a one line. So this is the script for jQuery. You can see I bring it into one line, and this link is for jQuery. You can see here, and the same way just here, this is the Owl Carousel link. So I will bring it into a one line. You can see, and this link used for Owl Carousel. You can see, so just this thing you have to be do, and after that here you will find the script code. This one you have to be copy the script code from here to just here. So I copied, and now here just I will paste this script. You can see here. So how it working, like, so guys, you can see here it's an ID, Owl Slider. So this ID, this Owl Slider ID here, you can see this one, and after that the property of Owl Carousel. These are for responsive. If your screen is mobile, tab, anything, so this is the link, I mean this is the property here. If your screen is 1000 pixel, so that time you it will get 4 item slider. If it is 600 pixel, 3, and if it is 0, I mean it's a mobile, so that time you will get 1 item slider. And this is the nav text, I mean for the button I have added the icon. And autoplay, that means the slider will be automatically play. And autoplay hover pause, that means when the slider will play automatically, but at this time if I hover on the slider, so it will be pause. And nav true, that means this is the nav, I mean button. So if I write nav false, so the button will not be shown, I mean it will be hide. So I have written nav true. And the margin, each item it will add a margin. And the loop true, loop true means suppose there is the 6 slider, and first view you are showing 6 slider, so you cannot slide, because loop it's a you, I mean you can slide, but if I write loop false, so that means the slider will not loop. I mean suppose you there is the 6 slider, and if you end the slider up to 6, so that time you cannot slide, because loop is false. If it is loop true, that means after end the 6 slider, then it will come from 1, that is loop true. Okay, I hope I can explain properly. And now I will save this one, and if I refresh my site, so you will find the Owl Carousel is implemented. So if I refresh, you can see here the Owl Carousel is implemented. You can see here. Okay, so here is the button in the left corner, I think you can see or not. So here is the button. Okay, so this is implemented, you can see. And here if I write the margin 30, so now it's some you can see the space is between 10 pixel, but if I write the margin 30, so if I refresh, so you can see it's added more space. This is actually margin. Okay, and this button icon here, that is nav, this one nav. Okay, so if I write here nav false, so you will find the icon is removed from here. So if I refresh, so you can see the icon is removed from here. So I need the icon, so I will write nav true, so you can see this one. Okay, and each slider has an image, so these are the images. So you can see these are the images. And the first of all, I have showing in the 1000 pixel, so my screen size width is more than 1000 pixel. I mean this is my screen size, so it's a more than 1000 pixel. So when it's 1000 pixel or more than 1000 pixel, so that time it will be shown here item support. So you can see I can see 1, 2, 3, 4 item. But if I write only 2 item, so save and refresh, so you can see I'm getting only 2 item. The same way if I write 6 item, so if I refresh, so now you can see I'm getting 6 item. So this is actually property of Owl Carousel. So now I will implement this carousel in my this product. Okay, so I will write here 3, because first of all I want to show 3 slider, because if I implement this slider, I mean this slider in this product, so first view here is the 3 product, so that's why I have added 3. And now I need the button, so I will write the net true, I will keep it. Okay, so this is done, and now this one I will implement in my this section, because this section is for this design. Okay, so first of all, just here I will cut all the item instead of one, I mean apart from one item, I will remove, I mean I will delete all the item. And now just I will copy this one, I mean not a copy, just I will cut this one, and here just I will minimize this row, and just here I will paste. And now here when I am using Owl Casual, so if I show here, you can see I don't need to write the row column, because Owl Casual is default grid system, has a default grid system. Just here you have to be right. So that is, if I come to the JS, so here you can see this works as a responsive and also as a grid. Like if I set the 3, so it will be a 3 column, and here it is, I set here 3, so that means it will be a 3 column on the when the screen size will be 600, and when the screen size is less than 600, so that time it will be a one grid, one column. Okay, so that works as a grid, I mean as a column also, so we don't need to write separately row and column like this one. Okay, so guys, here I will do one thing, just here I will cut in apart from this row and column, just I will cut the code means this code. Okay, so this product code I will cut, but I will not take row and column, because Owl Casual separately makes a row and column, so I will cut from here, and just here I will paste. Okay, and here now guys, I will do one thing, just I will copy this item class, this is in Owl Casual, and just here. Okay, so I will write deep, I mean I will paste this item class, and here also I will paste for another time. So the second item class, I will expand this second column, and I will cut this one, and just I will paste. And for the third column, here I will cut from here, and just here I will paste. And now this row I will delete, so I will delete these things. So now if I save and if I refresh here, so now you can see the Owl Casual is implemented here. So now you can see I can slide this thing. Okay, so this is done, I can slide this one. And now here I will implement the button, so here you can see this is the button. So I will do one thing, that is just I will copy this parent class, this policy product, because the I want to add the button design only for this slider. Okay, so now I will comes here first of all, and I will paste. And now just here I will inspect, so policy product, if I expand containers, this one, then Owl Casual, and this is Owl Nap. Okay, so this one is the Owl Nap. So here I will copy this Owl Preview, so here dot Owl Preview comma, and I will copy the same thing and paste. And now here I will copy this Owl Next, and I will paste here Owl Next. So this is done, and now I will add the CSS for this one. So guys, now here I will do one thing, now here I have the 3 column, I mean 3 item. Okay, and first preview here I am showing the 3 item, so that's why the Owl Nav button is not showing here, because here is the 3 slider, and the first preview I am showing the 3 slider, so that time there is no remaining item for slider. Okay, so I will do one thing. Just here first preview, I will show 3 item out of 4 item, but here is the 3 item out of, so it's showing 3 item out of 3 item, you can see. So I will do one thing, I will copy and paste here. So now just I will copy from here and paste. So now guys, here you can see there is the 4 item, and out of 4 item I'm showing 3 item. That means here it's showing 3 items. So I will save. So that means it's remaining 1 item for slider. So that time you can see the button is showing here. So now you can press the button, so it's sliding. Okay, so now I will add the design for this button here. So first of all I will add the background. So background color here I will write one, first of all RGBA, and 158 158 158 comma 0.6. and now guys here I will add height. So height here I will add 80 pixel and width 80 pixel, because I will add this button as a round. So height and width I will write the same, that is 80 pixel, and the button radius is 50%. So I will do save, and now if I refresh, so you can see here it's the round. So now I will just inspect this one, and I will add better design for this button. Okay, so here this one, just this background color here, just I will add more opacity. So this is now part. So I'll copy this background color from here, and just here I will paste instead of this one. So save, and now this is done. So now guys here I will write, because now guys here this button will be here and this button will be this side. So that time this button I have to make it float. So I will write here position absolute. So now here I will write position, that is absolute, and every button will be a middle, because this preview button will be here and this next button will be here. So every previous and next button will be middle from height, I mean top. So that's why here I will write top is 50%. But and guys, now the left button will be this side and the next button will be right side. So for the preview button it will be left 0 and the right button it will be right 0. So preview button, and this one is the next button. So now here I will write for the preview button left is 0, and for the right button, right is, I mean next button, right is 0. So now if I refresh, you can see the button is here. And now guys here I will write the another code for all this to preview and next button, that is transform translate minus 50% comma minus 50%. So that means transform translate minus 50%, that is it's make a strong of our CSS property left right top button. So I will do save, and if I refresh, so here you can see that. So now guys, this left button is perfect position, but the right button is not the perfect position. So here I will write this owl next. For this owl next here, this right I have to be add a more minus. So here 78 pixel is perfect. So here for the right I will write minus 78 pixel. And now I will add design for this icon, because this icon here you can see this icon is here, but before that I will increase the icon size. So here just here I will write font size, I mean every button there is the icon. So if I write the font size for for owl next and owl preview button, so it will be increase the font size of icon, means this one. So here I will write the font size 24 pixels. So now if I save, refresh, so you can see the icon size is increased. But now I have to bring this icon in middle, so I will do one thing, I will copy the same thing and I will paste here, and here owl preview. So this owl preview button has icon, so I tag, because if I show here, that is, here is the I tag, and this I tag, I mean this foundasome icon is coming here. So owl preview I and the owl next I. So here I will write position absolute, because I have to be bring this icon in the middle of this button. So position absolute, so top is from 50%, and from left it will be also 50%, and transform translate will be -50%, -50%. So this is done, and now if I save, so you can see now the icon is middle. And now I will do one thing, when I will hover on this button, so I will change the color of this one. So guys, here I will write transition here. So transition will be 0.3s all is, and now when I will hover, so I will copy this one and just here I will paste, and here for the owl preview I will write the hover effect, and for the owl next I will write the hover effect. So this I have written in one line, because they are the same CSS property will be for owl preview and owl next. Here is also the same, I have written it in one line, because here is the same CSS property for owl preview button and owl next button, so I have written it into a one line. Okay, so when I will hover on that, so first of all I will change the background color and also the color of the icon. Okay, so this icon color I will also change. So now here I will write first of all background, so background color will be FF, this color code orange color, and the color will be this time white. So this is done, save and refresh. So now if I hover, so you can see the color is changed. But guys, now the button size is it's showing too big, so I will decrease the size. Here I will write 60 pixel, and I will check it, it's looking perfect or not. So 60 is too small, so I will write here 70. So 70, I think it will be a perfect. So you can see 70 is now perfect size of this button. And this this right here I will write 74. So here now you can see not 74, here I will write 70. I think now it will be a perfect. Okay, now it's a perfect. Okay, so you can see it's sliding. And now here I will add the design for partner, and also I will add a slider for partner. So here now I will just minimize this one, and now here I will write section class partners. Okay, and here I will write deep class containers. This is not a bootstrap class, because in this containers class I have added my custom CSS property. I will show you here, you can see I have added custom CSS property for this containers class. So this one I have added here. Okay, and now I will add the slider. So I will go here, so script and everything is implemented. So now just I will copy the HTML code. Okay, so I will copy from here, and just here I will paste, and this div I have to be right for the end tag. So this is done. So now here this one. So now guys, this ID I already used for this slider. I mean if I show in the code, so this ID I already used. So I will change the ID. So here I will write the ID name is, that is partner slider. Okay, so this is the ID name. So I have to be do one thing, just I will cut, I will copy. So I will copy this code from here to here and just here I will paste. And now instead of this owl slider ID, I will write the ID name is partner slider. And for this partner slider, I don't need this button. So here I will write button is false. And on also I don't need the margin. So here I will write margin is 0. Okay, so this is done. And now here I will add the slider. So I will change the image name. So .images, and inside this partner folder there is the image. And here I will write the alter tag. So alter tag I will write partner. Okay, and same item I will copy and paste. And here just I will change the image name, and here I will paste and change into 3, and here paste change into 4, because I have 6 images. So I will add slider for 6 time, it's a 5 and it's a 6. So this is done, and here it's also done the code. So now if I save, so if I refresh, so you can see it's added a slider. And you can see I can slide only by my mouse. Okay, but here it's showing three item as a view, because here this partner, for the partner slider is 3 item, but here I will show 6 item. So I will write 6. So you can see here it will be shown the 6 item, you can see here. So this is done. And now here I will add some CSS. So I will copy this partners class, just here I will write, and first of all I will write the background color is white. So that means here it will be the background white. If I save, refresh, you can see the background white. And I will add the hover effect for these images. So here I will copy this partner and img, and here I will add a transition. Transition is all 0.3s and is, and I will add the hover effect on this image. So paste and hover. So when I will hover on this image, so that time just I will add a box shadow. So box shadow is 0 and 0, then 10 pixel, 1 pixel. So that means top is 0, right is 0, bottom is 10 pixel and left is 1 pixel. So this is done. Save and refresh. So if I hover, you can see that it's sliding, I mean it's a box hover. So I have to be change this hover effect. So now guys, here just I have added the box shadow, so it's showing the shadow, but here I have to be change into a color also. So the box shadow color will be this color, this grayish color. So save. And now here if I refresh, so now if I hover, so you can see it's showing a shadow, you can see here on the image. And now also I can slide of the image by mouse drag, you can see here. And now guys, here you can see there is the too much difference of this one, this section and this section. So I will inspect, and for this policy product section, if I write if I set the height is 470 pixel. So now you can see now it's looking better. So for the policy product class, here if I scroll up, and this one here I have to be set the height is 470 pixels. So save. And now if I refresh, so you can see now it's doing a perfect. So I can slide this one and this one by only mouse drag, and this one also I can slide by mouse drag, and also by the button also. So I hope you have understand how to implement the owl carousel. And if you find this video is helpful, so please like this video, and guys you can subscribe this video if you want to get more update this type of video.